So we need to. Now, basic things that recessive disorders, I'm sure by now you know how they are inherited and the possibilities and percentages and probabilities of the next generation, who's going to have the disease, who's going to carry it, who's going to be normal, okay? And also for dominant, you know the birds, but again, Dr. Anna highlighted yesterday much on the penetrance of the gene, even though dominant is known that 50% of the kids will have the disease, but that's not for sure. That's why we may intervene with recessive disorders, يعني intervene بمعنى نعمل ما يسمى avoiding having a baby with this disease or not. But for dominant, no, it's really something that you need to think twice about. Because you may have the defective gene, but the penetrance will be low for other reasons, so you may not have the disease, right? And you know the X-linked disorders, right? X-linked, yes. Connected to the X, okay, related to X of the during the inheritance, either recessive or dominant. وطبعا you know the multifactorial disorders, معروف ال prevalence مالها كم. In multifactorial disorders, هناك تكون المشكلة. The problem is there. How you can predict, يعني in the certain community, for example, the possibility of having an affected individual is 1 in 1,000. Okay. So how you will predict that this will really be inherited in the same percentage? The difference from community to community. Besides, there are other factors that you need to consider. ولذلك in literatures, الفكر معروف. يعني مثلا you will talk about multifactorial like مثلا neural tube defects. You will that 1 in 1,000. One case in 1,000 delivers. That's in every part of the world. But the difference from community to community. Yeah, for example, Down syndrome used to be 1 in 800. Now it is 1 in 350. Right? So it differs from community to community repeated and other associated factors. Sometimes we have some modifier genes. Modifier genes, يعني, besides that you have a defective gene, that can be modifier gene that may enhance the expression of that gene, so you will have the disease. While others they may have the same defective gene, like in modifiers are not affected, so that there is no modifier gene, so they will not have the symptoms. The most important is how to know and how to calculate things. Okay? في one formula يعني known long time back called Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium or Hardy-Weinberg formula or principle. And this formula actually discovered by two different scientists. One is named Hardy and the other is named Weinberg. Okay? And this formula actually, let us say that underlies within what's something called population genetics. And population genetics is studying the genes and defective genes and genetic disorders in the whole population. But this is a science by itself, it's in the population genetics. Right. So there are certain definitions I need you all to know about. What do we mean by population genetics? Population genetics, as I just said, that it is studying the inheritance or genetic disorders in the whole population. So studying Mendelian genetics in the henna. Will single gene defects particularly at the level of the whole population. Okay? So sometimes we approach certain population and want to know the frequency of a disorder. Yeah, for the next generation, what is the frequency of that feature or phenotype or disease in the coming generations? In any society, in any population. That kind of study as a whole is called population genetics. Okay? And there are certain formulas, calculations, you're gonna know about one today. And my colleague also will present the other one, okay? Now, in this Hardy-Weinberg, there are certain terms I need you to know before I go to it. What do you mean by the allele? Allele is a variant form of a gene. And in every locus, there are two forms of the gene. One is coming from father, one is coming from mother. So allele A, capital, or allele A, small, well, have the two forms of the allele. And the gene has two forms. Some diseases actually they need more than two genes to appear. So you may have three alleles, you may have four alleles, okay?
Normally it's only two.
Usually it's like that. So allele is a form of the gene, yeah, it's more than small gene, okay? Genotype. Genotype is the genetic constitution of an individual organism. بمعنى, في certain feature outside the person. يعني مثلا نفترض أن عندك كيف بلد, okay? Or we assume that he has some form of arthrogryposis. Or a chondroplasia, any feature outside. This feature we call it phenotype. Okay? So the symptoms appearing, we call it, or the signs, we call it phenotype. Now this phenotype is caused by genotype. Okay? So genotype means that genetic constitution that appear this feature. يعني مثلا either a disease or مثلا color of the eye, color of the hair, how tall is the person is, all other features. Yes. So we have phenotype, and the genotype is the genetic constitution that make the phenotype. But as a whole definition, it is the genetic constitution of individual organism. Okay. I'm sure you know about the Punnett square. Punnett square, يعني we use it during our high school studies. If you remember, the square we used to draw between AA capital and AA small. That's very important component of Hardy-Weinberg calculation. Okay. So the Punnett square is a diagram that is used to predict an outcome of a particular cross or a breeding experiment. Okay. So when there is two different genotype, we can predict what will be the possibilities of the next generation. And this is made for a square. Right. Now we know what is allele, and we know what is genotype, right? Okay? So there is something important you need to know, that what is allele frequency and what is genotype frequency, okay? In any population. So by definition, allele frequency is the relative frequency of an allele at a particular locus in a population, expressed as a fraction of percentage. Now, we said that a gene has different forms of alleles, right? Yes. And these forms of alleles we need to calculate in different locus of chromosomes. يعني مثلا, allele is here, allele is there, allele. So we need to calculate in certain population. So مثلا, we will, يعني frequency of this allele, for example, let us say that, let us say A capital. A capital is a dominant allele, okay? For anything, in any feature whatsoever, okay? So we need to know, to calculate the frequency of this dominant allele A, only A, in certain population. Okay, that will help us to know what will be the genotype frequency, because genotype frequency is built on allele frequency. Come on. So, in used to describe the amount of variation at particular locus or across multiple loci. So, the locus is the site. The locus is the site of the chromosome in which alleles are there. So, for single nucleus locus. For multiple, we said loci, right? Yes, yes. That describes the site of the gene and the locus. Genotype frequency, on the other hand, in the same population, describes the number of individuals with a given genotype divided by the total number of individuals. So genotype frequency is calculated by this. But anyhow, in Hardy-Weinberg, we'll be able to know the genotype frequency based on the allele frequency. Okay? Right. Now, the Hardy-Weinberg, different definitions, but they all focus on one similar definition, that is, allele and genotype frequencies in certain population will remain constant from generation to generation in the absence of other evolutionary influences. Evolutionary influences, يعني مثلا, selection and mutation, what's something called genetic drift or genetic flow change. So if these factors are away, then the frequency will remain the same from generation to generation. That Hardy-Weinberg assumption. And that's how the equilibrium is built on. So it also helps us to predict the allele and genotype frequency from one generation to the next in the absence of all those factors. As I said, and as I defined earlier, what is the allele frequency and what is genotype frequency? So this will help us a lot to predict in the next generation what will be such frequencies are. Now, just to know the history, Hardy-Weinberg was a work between an English mathematician, Hardy, and a German physician, Weinberg. But there are different stories around this. I mean, some say that it was discovered late after them by an American scientist. But what we know just in the history so far, that these are the Hardy and Weinberg who discovered this equilibrium that helped us a lot in the population genetics calculations. Right, okay, now, as we said, a single locus with two alleles, A and A. Usually we give the dominant capital, okay, and the recessive we give small. The dominant allele frequency of A, usually we give the figure P, remember that, okay? And the recessive will be given with the figure Q. So from that definition that will remain constant from generation to generation, then B plus Q will always be equal to 1. Right? This is for the allele frequency. Now for genotype frequency, so we know that genotype, you know, two alleles are there, right? Mm-hmm. Okay? So frequency of AA, the dominant one, that will be P times P, that's P squared. Okay? And for small a, which is the recessive, Q squared. Now, as we have also the homozygous A, capital, homozygous A small, and also we have a different genotype that will have both combination, A capital and A small. So that's genotype frequency calculated by multiply P and Q in 2. Now the formula of B plus Q equal to 1, if you square because two alleles, as I said earlier, it will show the same. P squared plus 2PQ plus Q squared will always be equal to 1. So using this formula, the Hardy-Weinberg calculation in population genetics will be implemented. Right, let us take an example now. But more explanation on that. As I said, the difference between the allele and the genotype, which I explained earlier, is very much important to know and to appreciate, because what we have in certain calculations or equations that sometimes will be given just a frequency. For example, the disease will appear in 9 out of 100, okay? So we need to know which is P, which is Q, which is P squared, which is Q squared, okay? By differentiating the allele between the allele and genotype frequencies. Now, P and Q have all allele frequencies. P squared, as I said earlier, represent the genotype frequencies. The allele frequencies are estimated of how common alleles are in the whole population. As I said earlier, how many we calculate in different loci, in all loci, in certain population. And the genotype is possessed by the individual principle, so there are two alleles present at each case. Okay, so the square always is genotype. Okay? The square root is allele. And this is the one square I told you about. It's very easy actually in Hardy-Weinberg. If you remember during the high school, when they discussed about the color of the eyes, about Mendelian experiment, right? Mm-hmm. So they use for A capital, A small, A capital, A small, and this is how it appears in the mean square. Right, now we'll go for an example. As it said here, that consider a locus that carries two alleles, A capital and A small. 10 individuals from that population, two alleles only, and three genotypes, right? Okay, three genotypes. A capital, A small, and A capital, A small. So three genotypes and two alleles. Now the frequency of AA is 6. Frequency of A capital A small 3 in that population. Total there are 10, okay? Frequency of A small is 1. Now this is how we calculate the number or the frequency of every allele, right? Let us consider A, okay? So the observed copies of A allele will be, because we have AA here too, 6, right? But we have 6 and AA, so 6 has to be multiplied by 2 to give us all A in that frequency. Plus, we do have 3A capital in that residence, okay? So 6 plus 2, 6 times 2 plus 3, we have 15 alleles of A. Clear, or shall I repeat again? Okay. Now, we want to calculate the A capital allele, right? As you can see here, the frequency of the genotype A is 6. And we know genotype because there are two forms of the allele, yeah, 2. So 6 multiplied by 2.
From where we
make it? Here, 6. And 2A, okay? Yes. So 6 multiplied by 2. Now, in the heterozygous, we have 1A, right? Yes. But in the homozygous recessive, we don't have A capital. Yes. So we don't count that, right? Yes. We are talking about A capital now, A capital. Yes. So 6 times 2 plus 3. Yes. Here we have 3 capital A and 3 A small, right? Yes. Okay? Yes. So 6 times 2 plus 3 is 15, so the frequency of allele at that particular around 15. Now we'll do the same for A small. As you can see here, we have 1 A small, right? The homozygous. So 1 times 2. Plus, we do have 3 A here. This 3 will apply for 2, A capital and A small. So 1 times 2 plus 3 are 5, right? So how many we have frequency A total? 20. Okay. Now to calculate the frequency of A, we need to divide 15 over 20, A capital. Right? So it will give us 0.75 and 75%. The frequency of allele A at that particular individual is 10, 75%. For A small, 5 over 20, it will be 25%. right? And because the formula remains the same, P plus Q equal to 1, right? I don't need even to do this, because if it is 75, then S1 will be 1 minus, okay? So, but we did it, show the same. Now, based on the allele frequency calculation, we can calculate also the genotype frequency. The same formula, right? Okay. Genotype frequency AA, B, which represents the allele capital, A, always, okay? The capital dominant are given, is given B. The recessive A or recessive allele is given Q, right? Okay. So since it is AA, so we need to square. So P plus B, B times B, which is 0.25. Who's have a calculator here? 0.75 times 0.75 will give us this figure, right? And for S more, 0.25 times 0.25 will give us this figure, right? And for to calculate the heterozygous, P times Q times 2, right? And you see the total is always 1, okay? So why I'm doing this, just to show you that this is the Hardy-Weinberg formula.
The heterozygous.
Yes. This is heterozygous. Heterozygous. We have homozygous A, homozygous A capital, homozygous A small, and we have heterozygous. Okay?
So it will be 2, B, Q, and...
Yes. You remember the square? How many we have A?
2.
Right? So, good. Shall I go back again to this example, or it's clear? Right. Now, we'll go through this practice. It said that 9 of 100 individuals in certain populations suffer from a homozygous recessive disorder. It's very much important to know. So we are talking about homozygous recessive, right? So which letter we are talking about? Which is Q. So the question is to calculate the frequency of the disease causing allele. By the way, we're going to have a practice in the group work. So some questions will be solved by allele. Right? Okay. Calculate the frequency of the disease causing allele and calculate how many heterozygous are in the population. So this is how we are using Hardy-Weinberg to predict the frequency of certain genotype in the coming generation. So first we need to calculate the frequency of the disease causing allele. Huh? Allele frequency, number one. Right, now, as it said in the question, we have 9 out of 100. So the frequency will be in percentage is 0.19. Of individuals are homozygous for recessive allele, and as you just said, this represents Q, okay? So Q squared, genotype frequency, Q is 0.3. So obviously, B will be 1 minus 0.3, so 0.7. Now, if we apply the same formula we took earlier, we can calculate the genotype frequency. If B is 0.7, then B squared, which is the genotype frequency, will be 0.7 times 0.7. If Q, in case Q is needed, then 0.3 times 0.3, right? But if you remember, the question is asking about what? How many heterozygotes in the population? So we are talking about the A capital S1. Right. So 2BQ, 2 times 0.3, 0.7 is 0.42 genotype frequency, which is 42%. So 42% of those will be heterozygous, or those population as we tell you. Right? Okay? Clear?
Yes.
Now, we're going to have one practical example in the group work, okay? And then that will work together. But one, I'll ask you more to work yourself, and I'll be with you. Okay, so two examples, right? So if you don't get the idea now, you'll get it inshallah from the practice. Thank you very much.